Your actions in the first few minutes of recognizing that a patient is suffering from cardiac arrest can make the difference between life and death. Here are the first three things you should always do when you encounter a patient without a pulse. Number one, call for help. If you are in the hospital, delegate another person to call a code blue. If you are out of the hospital, have another person call 911. Cardiac arrest cannot be managed by one individual. Appropriate care requires a full team of professionals. The earlier you call, the earlier help will arrive. Number two, start compressions. Push down on the center of the chest at a rate of about 100 to 120 compressions per minute. This is about the rate of the rhythm of the song Staying Alive by the Bee Gees. Allow for full chest recoil and minimize interruptions in chest compressions. Number three, delegate someone else to get the crash cart if you are in the hospital, or an AED if you are in the community. Set up the defibrillator or AED as soon as it is available. Continue compressions. If prompted by the AED to shock, do so immediately. If you see ventricular fibrillation or pulseless ventricular tachycardia on the crash cart monitor, defibrillate at 200 joules immediately. Resume compressions. The only two interventions that have been shown to improve mortality in patients with cardiac arrest are effective chest compressions and early defibrillation for shockable rhythms. Follow these steps and you have given your patient the best chance he or she could have had given the situation.